What's up, everyone? You saw the title, so let's dive right into how to install SKSE 64 for Skyrim Special Edition. First thing you need to do is head on over to the SKSE webpage at skse.serverlock.org and grab the right SKSE file. We want the 64-bit version, not the old 32-bit version for old Skyrim. This is probably where 90% of users who have problems with installing this make a mistake. They simply grab the wrong file. Just right-click and save the file somewhere convenient. For me, I'm going to save it right into my Skyrim directory. Once it's done downloading, you'll need to extract the SKSE files from the archive using 7-zip or something similar like WinRAR. If you're having difficulty extracting the files, head on over to the 7-zip website at 7-zip.org. Download the 64-bit installer for 7-zip and use that to extract the files. It's what I've used since I was still a little milk drinker, and it's never let me down. Open up the SKSE 64 folder that was extracted and move everything except the SRC folder into your Skyrim Special Edition directory. Now mine is installed on a secondary hard drive, so yours will most likely be somewhere else. By default, it will be on your C drive here. If you get a prompt to overwrite anything, just go ahead and click on yes. Once copied over, you're done installing. The only thing you need to do differently now is to use the SKSE Loader rather than the normal Skyrim SE launcher when launching the game. If you want some convenience, you can right-click the SKSE Loader and create a shortcut to it on your desktop or pin it to your start menu or taskbar. Now if you want to use the Skyrim SE icon on it so you can better recognize it, just right-click on your new shortcut, go to Properties, and click on the Change Icon button. Click on the Browse button, look for the Skyrim SE or Skyrim SE Launcher executables, pick one, then click on Open. The icon should already be selected, so just go ahead and click on OK buttons to finish up. Your icon should now be different. Now for mod organizer users, be sure to add the SKSE Loader as an application and use that when launching the game. Otherwise, you won't be able to load SKSE when launching the game. That's it. You should now be able to run the mods that require SKSE with Skyrim Special Edition. If you're still having trouble, be sure to double check that you grabbed the right file from the SKSE website, that you installed it properly, and that you're using the SKSE Loader to start the game. Failing all that, or if you just need help with installing other mods for Skyrim Special Edition, let me know in the comments below. Anyway, I hope this video helped. I'm Purple Derple, and I'll see you later. Peace.